Yes, good morning children. We are coming to the last part of the chapter. Three questions are included here in the from the exercise. What is artificial vegetative propagation? You know, artificial vegetative propagation is a method of reproduction in which plants are reproduced, plants are propagated by artificial methods. So by using artificial methods, plants are propagated. Reproduction by which the farmers adopt certain artificial methods. So these artificial methods are, you can see, cutting, then layering and cutting, layering, grafting and tissue culture. Grafting and tissue culture. So there are four types of artificial vegetative propagation. Okay. So first one is cutting. In cutting, what we do, we take the stem cuttings. We cut the stems into small pieces. For example, in sugar cane, we can see the stem is cut into small pieces. And the stem should have a node in it. A node. This is called a node. So that when the stems are put in the water, soil or water, the node produces the roots. Roots germinate from our roots produced from the nodes. So in cutting, the stem cuttings, root cuttings and leaf cuttings are used for reproduction. Whereas in layering we can see a plant which is growing. This is the lowermost branch of the plant, and the lowermost branch of the plant is bent down to the soil. Lowermost branch of the plant is bent down to the soil and covered with this soil. After some days we can see the roots start germinating or producing from this buried body, and from here we will cut it and grow as a new plant. So in layering, the lowermost branch of the plant is bent down to the soil and covered with the soil, and after some days we can see the roots start from this covered part. Then it will be cut and grow as a new plant. In grafting, on the other hand, the two plants are involved. The one plant which is in the pot or in the soil, which is a rooted plant, okay? The rooted plant which grows in the soil is called stalk. Stalk. S-T-O-C-K. To this stalk, scion. What do we call? Scion. Scion is a bud or a small branch. This scion will be grafted and tied with a thread or a polythene sheet. So the stalk is the rooted plant to which scion, which is a bud or a twig of the plant, which is joined together. Now before joining, we must cut the joining part so that the stalk and scion will be contacted, and that will be tied with a thread or polythene sheet. After some days, the stalk and scion together grow as or together become a single plant. So cutting, layering and grafting are the common methods of artificial vegetative propagation. Tissue culture is a modern method of artificial vegetative propagation or asexual reproduction, in which the tissues taken from the plant is grown in the culture medium under controlled laboratory conditions. So tissues taken from the plants are grown in the culture medium. Culture medium contains lot of enzymes and hormones. These hormones and enzymes will help in the growth of the tissues. And tissues divide and redivide and form new plants out of it. Okay? So, cutting, layering, grafting and tissue culture are the common methods. And this explanation I already completed in our live class. Okay? Now, what does the process of fertilization consist of? Actually, fertilization consists of pollination and the fusion of male and female gametes. You know, we have already discussed pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma. After pollination, you can see the pollen tube is formed. This pollen tube carries the male gamete, and it will come to the ovary. Inside the ovary, there is ovule. Inside the ovule, we can see the female gamete called egg. This Male gamete will be released into the egg, and male gamete fuses with the egg to form zygote. This process is called fertilization. So the fertilization consists of important two steps: pollination and pollen germination. Pollen grain germinate by using the sugar present on the stigma. Sugar and other chemicals present on the stigma. By using that, they germinate and produce pollen too. Okay, right. Now we are coming to the last part of this. When does the seed start germinating? Seed start germinating when the favorable conditions are available. Okay, what are the favorable conditions? Moisture, warmth, oxygen, and soil. Moisture, warmth, oxygen, are the major favorable factors for the seed germination. Suppose a seed is in the soil, water is there. Now the seed absorbs water by osmosis or diffusion. Okay, now it swells up. When the water enters into the seed, the food stored, particularly starch stored in the seed, will be soluble. Okay, dissolved in water, so that the embryo can absorb the food. The embryo consists of two parts: plumule and the radicle. Embryo consists of two parts. After absorbing the food from this seed, the embryo now start germinating. Okay, embryo now starts. This embryo, the part of the embryo which comes down to the soil is called radicle. The part of the embryo that comes down to the soil is called radicle. So what it is? Radicle. R-A-D-I-C-L-E. Radicle produce roots and they fix the plant in the soil. And the upper part of the embryo is called plumule. What it is? Plumule. Now plumule goes up and produces small leaves. So the plumule of the embryo becomes the shoot or the stem. Shoot means stem plus leaves. Okay, and some branches. So the plumule grows into the shoot system and radicle grows into the root system. So when the favorable conditions such as oxygen, warmth, and moisture is available, the seeds start germinating. The germinating seeds absorb water and become soluble. The food, particularly starch stored in the seeds, will be soluble in the presence of water, so that the embryo can absorb. Embryo is a small plant inside the seed. Embryo has two parts, radicle and plumule. Radicle comes out first to become the root, and the plumule becomes the shoot. Okay, that's all from this part. Thank you.